gentlemen, now it is time. It's a segment that everyone looks forward to, one of the highest rated segments of all time that I've ever done. All right? Ladies and gentlemen, it is time. Phil's Day Off.
What's up, Piggy? Let's get it started.
Big ups, here, cat.
It's my day off. Might leave the can, but on a jerk off. It's my day off. Spend money on pulls and dumb shit. It's my day off. Might go out with my bitch wife, cat. Give me money today.
This is where my fucking money goes to every month. Garbage dump, grocery shopping, paying my taxes, pet store, paying my bills. Blowing his money on mobile games, blowing his money on this and that. I'm spending all this money by DoorDash for my business. I need to put disgusting food in the mouths of my family members. Obviously, I need tips. Yes, I spend money on mobile games. Okay? These are my life priorities. Paying my taxes.
It's my day off. Might leave the can, but on a jerk off. It's my day off. Spend money on pulls and dumb shit. It's my day off. Might go out with my bitch wife, cat. Give me money today.
Obviously, I need tips.
Give me money today.
This is where my fucking money goes to every month.
Shout out to the trolls.
For those who contributed, thank you. It would be great if we get a few more tips. To make up earlier today, we did not hit the hat goal either. It's been a very slow day. It would be great if we could pick it up a little bit with maybe some contributions tonight with tips. If you can. Just saying. You know, I know some people are super chatting or whatever. That helps long term. But right now, I really can help. Tomorrow's my day off. The tips I'll have for my day off, you see?
Give me money today.
I actually admitted this last year. I'll say it again. I actually do play some mobile games. I do. All right? The ones that I play are free to play or incredibly inexpensive, like you spend a dollar here or there to make progress.
This one's for all my baby girls.
Got me that gotcha.
I love it.
Got me that gotcha. Gotcha. Begging for fucking tips and shit on Street Fights. WWE champions.
I'm
stupid. WWE game plays like Candy Crush. Moving gems around. Breaking colored gems.
I love it.
Again, it's pay to win. The more money you sink into it, the more characters you can summon, the higher chance you'll get the better characters, etc., etc. All right. Got me that gotcha.
I love it.
Got me that gotcha. Begging for fucking tips and shit on Street. Gotcha. Got me that gotcha. Thanks for the money, dummies. Supercar. That was a mobile game I played like 5-6 years ago, a lot. For about a year, I played it pretty hardcore, all right? Even at that point, that was before everything kind of fell apart with YouTube and everything. I was putting a little bit of money into it. I was playing for the top cards. I was playing the shit out of that game, okay? After about a year, they launched what they called Season 2, which reset all the cards in the game and made all your progress essentially worthless. And I said, this game fucking sucks. What a complete waste of time that this was, all right?
Now, what does the sugar do in the sauce?
Add sweetness, adds a contrast. If you don't, it's all going to be tartness, and you won't have any kind of sweetness.
It's going to be acidity from tomatoes.
Right, you'll have tart and it's acid and nothing else. All right. So now we're going to stir all that in, and then we add our final ingredients, and then the meat.
This one's for all my baby girls.
Italian wife. Italian wife. Italian bills. Italian dark side fit. Italian wife. Italian wife. Italian chill. Italian
can't give her a pill. I'm half kind of European mix. European style, Asian fusion style. Tips. Greasy hair. Pasta once a week. Authentic style, Asian fusion style. Italian.
Guess what else we're gonna add?
What?
Sausage. Italian sausage. That's gonna go in here too.
I love sausage. I have had many varieties.
Italian wife. Italian wife. Italian bills. Italian dark side fit. Italian wife. Italian wife. Italian chill.
Italian. Can't give her a pill. Why do you pretend to be Italian? I don't. I'm not full-blooded Italian. That'd be ridiculous for me to claim. I am a quarter Italian. I am one quarter Polish. And I'm half kind of European mix.
Why do I say I'm not a children's entertainer? Because I'm not a Muppet. I'm not here to play a character. I'm not here to pretend that I'm something that I'm not. I don't dye my hair. I don't act stupidly constantly to get attention from children. I don't do stupid pranks. You know what I mean? I don't cause drama. I'm here just to play games and have fun. I'm a legitimate gamer.
Big up here, Dad.
I need banana, tasty banana. Put banana in my mouth, tasty banana. I need banana, tasty banana. Please don't peel it, comes in dinner. Put banana in my mouth, squeeze banana. Put banana in my mouth, in my mouth. Squeeze banana.
Act and talk a certain way with certain mannerisms, certain over-the-top reactions, screaming at the top of their lungs, jumping, flailing, doing weird things, constantly on camera.
I need banana, tasty banana, put banana in my mouth, tasty banana. I need banana, tasty banana, please don't peel it, comes in dinner, put banana in my mouth, squeeze banana. Banana in my mouth, in my mouth. Squeeze banana, squeeze banana. Put banana in my mouth, in my mouth. I need banana, tasty banana. Put banana in my mouth, tasty banana. I need banana, tasty banana. Please don't peel it, comes in dinner. Put banana in my mouth, squeeze banana. Put banana in my mouth, in my mouth. Squeeze banana.
When we hit the 250 vestry for that celebration, I'm going to debut a new vest. There we go. Celebratory bubble blow. Very nice. There's bubbles everywhere. There's bubbles all over my PlayStation 4 controller. There's bubbles on my microphone stand. There's bubbles everywhere tonight.
Because you're not rich and you're not famous and you're not this and you're not that. You had an opportunity to be, but you blew it all. And I said, well, oh well. I'm proud of that. I guess I'm proud to be a loser.
This one's for all my baby girls.
I'll be the guy on level one. I streamed myself masturbating. I'll be the guy.
Fuck life.
I'll be the for the thousands of children. I'll be the guy on level one.
You're still on mission one.
I'll be the guy. Level one. Married happily, paycheck to paycheck happily, meaningful relationship, meaningful life with a family. And that, by the way, I have to raise money to pay 2 week bills next week. All my utilities are due next week. Tomorrow, if I stopped streaming, I would not be able to get a job. So it would be the end of my life. But outside of that, everything else is good in my life. You know what I mean? So I'll be the guy on level one. Streamed myself masturbating. I'll be the guy.
Fuck life.
I'll be the for the thousands of children. I'll be the guy on level one.
You're still on mission one.
I'll be the guy. I'll be the thousands of children.
When your life is all positive instead of negative, it's a much better situation. Big up to your dad. And I can tell you that from personal experience. Look at my life now. I have a beautiful life with a family, right? Everything here is so much better than what I had before. Why? Because I'm a positive person.
That being said.
Hello, hello. This is Phil. Phil Burnett. All right. And just wanted to tell you that I love the podcast. That being said, big ups. That being said, which vest is podcast best? That being said, relaxing, chill, interactive, fun. That being said, which vest is podcast best? That being said, relaxing, chill, interactive, fun. A.L. Team Insider, the legend.
fantastic Mr. Sam, the dentist, Steve to the dead, psychological style host,
get well soon, man,
me your cat, artistic style host, that being said, which vest is podcast best, that being said, which vest is podcast best.
If there is ever meaningful content, it's being produced right here on That Being Said.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Thursday, we're here. It's time for That Being Said to control Thursdays, dominate Thursdays, as our internet is up. Unlike Phil was trying to trying to drum up that drama and saying, well, I hope my internet works tomorrow, guys. Anyways, Sam's back in the house, Meerkat's in the house, and we are going to go to Meerkat for very important business-style announcements. Go ahead. Come on.
Bro, everybody, listen up. It's over. After this stream, the King of the Ring deadline has been closed.
Yes.
But we would like to say, on a positive note, that we've got a tidal wave of people who submitted their stuff. We might even hit, like, 50 this
yes.
year.
Yes.
It's crazy. I logged into the email today. I hadn't done it in like a week. And it was just like top to bottom. It was just ka-ching, ka-ching, ka-ching.
Yeah.
And it was like five people in the last 2 days that did it. So it's a ton of hype. We're expecting super positive and fun stuff. And I guess that's kind of it. There's no more business. You guys know what's up. We're going to listen to your messages today that you sent us very graciously and beautifully and amazingly. And we're going to be listening to him.
Yep. And what about the ka-ching of the ring? Obviously, it's going to be a three-hour show. It has to be. Just get ready for that. Three-hour hype coming in that stream because there's too many songs. Lemtex is going to be there. That will be 2 weeks from today, I believe, is the date we decided, right? 2 weeks from this day right now as we speak.
Well, I believe so, yeah.
Yes, 14th. Okay. So
sounds like
14th of March is the final date we are doing it. You know, March 14th. Okay.
The thing we gotta actually talk about behind the scenes is finally settle on what the winner actually gets.
Yes.
Because it's a competition, but the reward on top, you know, it's kind of vague right now. You don't know what it is.
So besides a lifetime of fame and fortune, we need to decide what else they get from us. Yes, that is very true. We'll figure that out. Do not worry. So March 14th is the final day. We'll make sure every video has a lyric video this time. Lemtex in the house is going to be very hype. I cannot wait for that, man.
We got people preparing multiple songs because they're so confident in their first song that they also have one for the finals ready to go.
Yes.
last year was like the first ever. Nobody knew what it was like until they showed them. And this year, they know, like, they know how the game is played.
Yes.
They're showing up.
Yes, yes. And it's insane. And people had their songs ready for months. You know, I know a lot of people were like that. And let me tell you, I think everybody that made the finals put a song in, I believe, except for Lefty. Lefty's the only one that hasn't yet. But I think almost everyone that had a song in the finals has a song in there, and a lot of people from the first round as well. It's got to be very hype. We'll keep telling you about it as we get closer. But other than that, let's get to what's going on today as Philip is, of course, playing as we speak Final Fantasy VII. Sam also very hyped about Final Fantasy VII. Did you also get a cloud wig, Sam, for you to enjoy Final Fantasy VII?
I unfortunately don't have a cloud wig. No, that's something that's missing from my wig collection. I've only just seen it. ALT's yes. just showed me the cloud wig, and it's definitely a blonde wig. As for the accuracy of the actual hair, maybe when he puts it on, it'll just like take shape. And
oh yeah, well you saw the Ken, right? Or the Karen one. That was great. That worked perfectly.
I can't wait for someone to like find it on Amazon and find out what the wig's actually called. Like, you know, is it like anime?
Exact one.
Is it just like anime hair, like gentleman's anime hair or something like that?
Gentleman's serious gamer hair. Yes.
Yeah. You know what he did? He does the gimmick thing whenever he gets a new like a new hat or he has a new animation to show. Instead of showing it or putting on the hat, he would just show it on his hand. So he put the wig on his hand. So you little cucks in the DSP chat, you need to hit that contribution goal if you want to see him actually put it on. He can't give it for you for free.
Yes. And yeah. Also, apparently, Steve already found it. Steve of the bed. Steve on the mat has found it. So we got to, I'll check it out and get it up to you, Sam, if you want to play it. But worth pointing out, though, guys, he does not have just a wig. We have also rearranged our support goals for this.
Oh, shit.
Normally, on a DSP stream, I'll let you know, $50, you get Gunner glasses. So that's, I know, that's hype. That's already get your blood flowing. On $100, though, we put a hat on, all right? And then at $150, we get the vest. You all know it, right? You know the deal. But now, since we have this hype item, what do you do if you're a business major like DePhilip Brunel? You switcheroo-ski the vest and the hat. So you get maximum money. Yeah, that's brother. What you go. That's what valedictorians do. All right. So big ups, dude. Awesome. Nice. Way to milk. I mean, that is how you milk.
That's one way of doing it. Yeah.
Exactly. He accused us of milking not for sustenance, but I believe he's milking right now, not for sustenance either. Damn. Hell yeah.
Today, also, by the way, for those who haven't seen it, you should definitely go and watch his rant about Neil Druckmann. You might be surprised there was one, because, I mean, how many rants can he have about Neil Druckmann? But this one was mega toxified and full of projecting. Like, this dude might as well have been talking to a mirror the whole time. It would make perfect sense.
Why does he hate him again? He's always hated him, hasn't he? This is a long time feud.
Because Neil Druckmann is like a pretentious asshole. He is successful and he puts like wokeism and wokeness in his games. And he's kind of an obnoxious guy. But like DSP got like an actual feud, like a personal vendetta with this guy for some reason.
Well,
maybe because there was sex in The Last of Us 2. And there wasn't in the first game.
Son of a bitch. The kids shit. Like 8-year-olds writing games. I hate this shit. Like you said about the bear fucking. That it's like written by an 8-year-old. When I was 8-year-old, would you think about fucking bears? I wasn't personally. And I'm a horn dog. I'll tell you that right now. But
horn
dog. Dolls? Horn dog? All right, anyways. Let's get to it. Samuel, please, hit us with our first message. We'll see where the conversation takes us. Come on.
Okay, let's do it. Let's hear from Samurai's first of two.
What's going on, guys? Samurai's here.
Hold on.
I'm catching up on some WPIG stuff right now.
We rarely recognize those because we don't get to see them on the back end. But Richard just tipped us $16.51. Thank you,
Bingo.
Richard.
Bingo. Bam, Richard, you're a legend. Also, thanks for...
Can we get a message on that?
Yeah, dude, where's the message on there, Samuel? I can check it. Hold on. Hang on, Richard. You're a legend, and I want to make sure you get full shout-outs. Let's get on the leaderboard, Richard. Hang on. Richard, R-I-C. Okay, you play the message, though, and I'll get it.
Okay.
Samurai, I'll get it.
Here we go.
Now I'm watching the Tips Goal episode, and I've only made it to the Zombie Skittles section, and I might have to tap out already. Like, this 40-year-old man is treating Skittles like cyanide pills. You know,
he's
like concerned that like eating the whole bag is gonna give him a sugar high, and it's just so bad for his health. And they eat like you know this, that, and the other, all his bull crap. And we know why he does it. He's trying to like convince his dents that they aren't spending $20 to have him eat a single Skittle. Uh-huh. He's trying to make it seem like, oh, it's so bad for my health. Oh, I could get the nasty zombie one. Woo! You know, hashtag not a children's entertainer. Uh-huh. But, like, it's just, it's pathetic. It's embarrassing. Like, I don't know any other way to describe it. I get secondhand embarrassment from it. But I just wanted to come on here and rant about that. And then I'll also ask you guys, what's the most embarrassing / pathetic thing Phil has done for money, in your opinion? All right, you guys have a good one. Take care.
Ooh.
Now Skittles is close, but I still hold out for shaking the fishing lure in front of the camera.
Oh yeah, dude,
that has to be it. That has to be it. The holding while saying I don't. That same month or whatever, he said I don't do dunce luring, and he held up a lure and shook it. That's the best.
Yeah, it was definitely one of the more bizarre like little story arcs. That for sure.
Oh, definitely, definitely. But any other choice, though, Meerkat? What's else,
Sam?
In your mind? Yeah.
Embarrassing. For money. See, I don't know why, but I was thinking of the push-ups, but that wasn't even for money, was it? I don't think it was just like.
That was a challenge.
Just a random thing.
Yeah.
come back to me. I'll have a think.
I gotta say, it's not worse than the Dunslores, but right when the Vest streak ended, he was so desperate to have another one that he wanted to put on like two vests at a time, and he actually tried it.
Yes.
If you look up Double Vest on PickPickGo, you're going to find it. It's a really juicy fucking segment. It's really funny. And I think that's super like humiliating for him because the one streak that was like 276 days, goddamn, actually streams.
Yes.
But it's still insane. And then he tried to do it again. And you know, like when a show tries to reach the pinnacle that it once had, they end up jumping the shark, and this shit with the Double Vest was so embarrassing that he even thought he could pull it off.
I watched the WPAG on all those fucking tips goals, and it's amazing how he fought back on every single goal. He did not want to wear the vest at the beginning. I don't want to wear the stupid vest. What are you guys dumb? But it kept that made it become a meme in their chat. So like it just the ounce of naturalness, you know, like people like, I want to see that vest, Phil. And then Phil jumped on it, and then it became this thing that the chat kind of naturally happened. But after that was over, Phil tried to manufacture memes, and that's why they all failed since then, because you can't manufacture them. They just kind of have to happen. That's why the vest streak went so long, I think, because that was really a chat creation thing. Phil has many times said, I don't want to wear this stupid vest. It's hot in here. Before it started, the vest, and then he finally did it, and then he saw, like, holy shit, these people are dumb as fuck. They'll give me money for this? All right.
Yeah.
And then he kind of jumped on it, and then it became this cool thing that he loves. It's a symbol, right?
Yeah. Well, that's, like, Oh, you go, Meerkat.
I think it was pretty organic for about the first, I don't know, maybe, like, 2 weeks. And then everything became about the vest streak. It was, like, 10 times a day. Oh, you guys, I don't know if you're going to hit it. We might not hit it. It might be over today, you guys. It might be done. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. And then like 10 minutes before the end, somebody bails him out. Because you know what they do? They wait for the last like 10, 15 minutes to see how much money left they got to donate. And they just send him that so they don't have to pay the full amount.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, I was going to say it started out as like this organic thing, as I've mentioned before, I think. And so people, you know, genuinely were like interested in it. Wasn't something that was something he tried to manufacture, you know, like the lures or like any other of the other things where it's just like, you know, he tries to make it a thing like the eight ball or the whatever. It was an actual thing. It was like, remember this thing? Hang on, let me see if I've still got it. You know, and he goes and he brings it back and it's like, ah, cool. You know, you don't get those moments very often with him. I think that may have been one of the only times it happened. I was just thinking, like, for mine, maybe, I mean, I don't know if it's embarrassing, but the whole, like, the trying to own the alcohol thing, I think is pretty damn embarrassing.
Pretty bad, too, yeah.
It's not like funny, ha-ha, it's just kind of sad, you know, but I think it's
up
there.
This is where we're at now,
sure.
Definitely a really good point with alcohol, because that, out of all those things, that degrades him the most as a person, as like an actual human being. Because he's coming out saying that, okay, this almost ruined my whole life. I was super miserable. I was an alcoholic. It destroyed me. But I'm willing to take a shot for $100. $100 is $100, you guys.
Yeah.
So I'm looking to get tipsy today. Where them money at?
Yeah.
So, yeah. That's
like, you know, he's far away from this person, but it's very much only use me blade, right? Like everyone knows he shouldn't be drinking alcohol, but they give him money just so he does drink the alcohol, like literally trying to kill him. Like DSP's not on that level, but it's one step away. That's one step away. People paying to kill someone in a roundabout way, you know? You know, but
you guys, since we were on the vest streak, you guys remember the rebooted vest streak that Jinx started like, I don't know, a year ago or something?
Yeah.
So it was just this one guy who was wailing out so hard. The vest was like he recreated the vest streak. His power was so astonishing that he managed to raise the vest from the dead and create his own vest streak that died around like 7 or 8. Because I mean, in the end of the day, you got to send this dude $100 every day. It's not gonna last too long.
Yeah, no one else cared. It was like, all right, well, this is your thing, so you go ahead, bro. Yeah. We'll let you throw money at it, but we're not doing it.
That's exactly why DSP started disliking it in the end, because he realized that once Jinx sends him like $100, everybody else is like disincentivized from contributions, and he doesn't want it to be like that.
Yeah, that's when you can. That's when you really start to think. You know, you can't call this crowdfunding. This is, you know, this is single person funding, and it, you know, it may not always be the same person, but it's one of how many? You know, five, or, if that.
Or at the very least, you could say it's a sense of obligation people have. Yeah. That's the kind of mood he's created. Because other people on the internet, when you get money, it's like you kind of have a hype thing. You know what I'm saying? Can kind of happen, you know, like, whoa, hype train, let's do this, cool. We're all kind of working together to make this streamer happy.
Yeah, but and you Phil get that
the
kind
exact
of,
opposite, you know?
You get that, the sense of, like, joy from being a part of the group. Plus, you also get to affect the streamer themselves. You get to see what their reaction is, and it's like a really kind of human, you know, outpouring of like, whoa, you know, like even now it happens with the big streamers, you know, like we were saying before the stream, Max had what 40k on his stream, and you know, it never stops being amazing to him. But with DSP, you're right. Yeah, obligation's a great way to put it. It's like, it's never genuinely, he never expresses genuine happiness with it. Or if he does, it doesn't come across, you know, it's never that kind of human. It's kind of like, oh, thank you very much. You know, like kind of, you get a quick thank you and then move on.
Yeah, so, he berates you if it's not enough. He'll say like, oh, all right, guys, that's $2 in tips today. you know.
Yeah, he started getting annoyed at the 1 minute man tips recently. Especially today, I noticed it. Cause so first he receives a tip, then he like leans into the chat and starts reading the message, and it's like, you know, it's like paragraphs of shit about Baldur's Gate 3. Cause now 1 minute man is super talkative apparently, and then he starts saying, "Well, 1 minute man, you said a lot of like interesting stuff, but sadly, it's not pertinent to today's stream." And then he got, you know, that like little like condescending talking to that a cuck gets when he gets out of line. That's what 1 minute man did. And that guy has sent unironically actual thousands of dollars to this guy. Actual thousands. $25, maybe sometimes 20 every single day. Like actually every single day.
Yeah, it's up to like almost 10,000, I thought. 8 or 10,000 or something. Like throughout the years.
If anyone deserves like Derek levels of like diplomatic immunity in his community, it's 1 minute man. Assuming 1 minute man is one man and not, you know,
imagine someone giving you $15 a day, whatever the fuck you want. All right, that's a great question. Great thought there, you know. Amazing thought there, dude. And he's not even being like toxic, he's just being like talking about points he wants to share. You're being toxic, that's different, but he's not even being toxic. He's just like, you know, like asking questions about stuff. All right, well, hold on now. That's not really pertinent right now. Like
clearly fucking loves this game.
Like being a DSP fan, like if he knows that you're a fan and that you've been around for a long time and you've been a cuck, he expects you to act a particular way. So if you step out of line, he gets salty at you in a very specific way that he doesn't towards trolls.
Yeah,
because he like expects you to know how to act. Like you should know not to derail my stream when it's not fucking Baldur's Gate Day. You don't talk about that game. You talk about the game you're supposed to talk about. And today, by the way, another update, because I'm gonna forget by Sunday. Plus, I'm not gonna be here.
Yeah.
So he talked how today his stream started an hour early because I guess he had some personal stuff to do later. Whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
And he said that he told this to his fans and only like 10% of them listen. And he said this with like a lot of like condescending, patronizing saltiness to it. Like you were late for class. Like the teacher told you class is going to start an hour early and then you were late. You didn't show up. You fucking idiots. You have to be there.
He's very much a teacher, a kindergarten teacher. You know, I mean, that's how he is. He operates his shit like that. And like, imagine it. Like, because if he didn't make people feel like shit for giving like $2, I think more people actually would. Because people feel like, all right, fuck it, I'll, you know, okay, I want to support Phil. I only got $1 though. Now, if I'm sitting there eating my crayons, but I only got $1, I'm not gonna donate. I feel like shit. I don't want to get berated. You know, fuck that. I'll hold on to my dollar.
And another epic segment before we move on, because I'm gonna forget it again. They had burgers, some like gourmet, high level cuisine burgers. But 10 minutes before this story, he was saying how especially today is a very important day where you should send him YouTube side contributions because next month he is going to be penny pinching. He's going to be on a very tight budget. And yeah, you guys keep out for all those Phil's Day Off segments and all that kind of stuff that they've had. Also, today was like a treasure trove of burgers. There was so many of them.
I've heard about this. I haven't clipped any because I wasn't listening to it, but I've got some from his React the other day, though.
Oh, nice.
There were some special ones.
You can play it from the Discord. Thankfully, shout out to Messi Style member who clipped a bunch of burgers. Oh, like he clipped like five of them.
Legend. Okay.
Excellent.
I did find Richard's comment. Richard said, donating some pools for the Kachiga the Rink. Thank you so much, Richard, for that nice message. And we will definitely get the pools ready for you there. A few shout outs before we get going here. Battery exhausted in the house. Thanks for the gift, member bomb, dude. Joe Dub says, I'm going to match that tip. Don't let the hate get to you, dude, and all that good stuff. Yeah.
You know what? You know what? Thanks for saying that, Joe Dub. I take that hate and I fuel me. I use that hate to fuel myself. You know what? A lot of people said that when I first started this in 2014. Whatever. I'm done. I could go forever, but I won't. Big Ups Boat Knight, where am I playing? You still haven't told me. Thank you so much, Boat Knight. Maximus in the house says, Sam style question. Is Sam secretly 008 or working for the KGB? So what do you think, Samuel? Is that true?
Yes. Yeah, one of those. I can't say which one it is, but you're getting closer.
He's busy. Dentist, that's all front, you know? Mm. Next up in the house is Mad Max, the seventh. Big ups from the member bomb as well. Cope's side Phil saying his commentary for Final Fantasy VII today is unbearable. I'm going to listen to it now, thank God. And Aid Robertson in the house. Big ups, TBS, Aid and Becca. Thanks so much, everybody.
Hey, shout out to Aid and Becca.
Legends, true legends, highest order. All right, next message. Great question to start us off, Samurais. That got us going.
Excellent. Yeah, here's Condo Kevin.
Hey, Condo Kevin here, first time caller. What do you think is up with a 1 minute man going from never saying a single word to
not on time,
like being extremely talkative? I think it's really strange, but I wanted to hear your guys' opinion. Thanks.
Wow.
We just talked about it, but I think, you know, good question. Very pertinent question. Great question. I think maybe he's saying, you know what? I want a little bit more for my money. Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically.
That's what I'm thinking too.
I don't want to just get berated for nothing. I want to actually share my opinions.
Yeah.
It can't last forever, though.
Every time he sends a message, DSP explains it like it's Ask the King, you know? He goes into further detail than he would a normal message because, I mean, it's 1 minute, man. Come on. It's like,
he's not like saying crazy stuff, but he's definitely saying things that are just slightly against DSP's mindset. You know what I mean? Like you talked about the Baldur's Gate sex stuff, you know, like it's just a part of the game. You don't have to choose to enjoy it. And Phil shot back at that. I didn't hear what he said today, but today seems even worse. So maybe we're going down a path here where 1 minute, man.
That's the thing, though. It kind of exposes DSP's lack of passion, doesn't it, really? Where you've got someone that clearly likes something, so much so that it's got them talking.
Yeah.
Whereas before, they were just giving money and not saying anything. And then DSP has, because obviously he feels like he has to kind of put some sort of spotlight on it. He can't just brush past it, as much as he may appear to be. I don't know, but I'm not seeing all of them, but I'm guessing he... For a lot of the time, he'll put a bit of special emphasis on 1 minute man's messages. But at the same time, it's about a game he clearly has trouble with and has no passion for, and is being handheld through. So yeah, it kind of the two butting against each other is kind of fascinating.
And I think he got a little too used to just like putting the money in the cash register. Shout out 1 minute, man. Thanks for your daily contribution. We just move on. And now it's like, I got to do something. This guy is asking me to have an opinion. Come on. What the fuck?
What am I?
The ideal pay pig for DSP is a guy that tips often significant amounts. I mean, like double digits. Preferably the first one is not going to be a one.
Oh, hell no.
And they say nothing. They have no identity on the internet. They're like a complete sock account and it's tips. Or it's gifted memberships, but nowadays that's a little bit different.
Yeah, those are kind of, big question mark on those. Yeah. That's funny. Like, that's what a life. DSP's pissed like 1 minute man is making him do work. And when I say work, it's reading his thoughts.
Yeah.
It's like, It makes me think of like a sugar baby, and the sugar daddy every once in a while was like, well, today I can't just give you like $1,000 to go to the mall. You gotta earn it, you know. Come over to my place. You gotta bust that shit wide open. You know what I mean? You gotta actually work your money this time.
But like, it's not even like sexual. Just like, read my comment. Like, yeah. All right, hold on a second. That's a little bit too much. God damn it. Oh, big up. Oh, like some rice in the house. Big up. Says diverse coin. Phil files and not cat. Big ups, boys. 0.0 chance of Phil finding.
Can't even file his taxes.
Nope. Why start now? Filing anything. Good thought, though. Like some rice. All right, let's go, Sam. Next one in the house. Come on.
Okay, let me just hear this for a sec.
There's a place out here that they have char burgers.
Okay,
char
thank you.
Burgers. That's a nice
char
one.
Burgers. Right.
Okay. Right. Big ups to a messy style member. Maybe I'll just pepper these in throughout the show.
Please hit us with them. Pepper.
As well as these that I clipped the other day. Here you go.
Tarantula burger.
Oh yes.
That from tarantula burger.
It nice. Was great. It was literally just a. I'm guessing people do this to bait him to say burger a lot. It's got to be happening. Yeah. But yeah. It was literally just about a burger place. And they serve a tarantula burger. It's literally a burger with a tarantula on it. And he said burger at least 3 times. So thank you, whoever that was.
Now our Jonathan Frakes questions are going to be tougher, too, because he's on to us. He recognized it now. Yeah,
that's what I wanted to ask you. What's the status on that? What's the progress?
We're about 75% of the way done. But now he realized people like, all right, some people are trying to ask the same questions, and irrelevant questions, you know, and he kind of knows it. Because, like, people are asking the same shit, but it's still the best.
Yeah.
We flew too close to the sun for a little bit. People asking about, like, have you ever go wandering in the blue sky or something? And, like, that's kind of tough.
You should have kept it under wraps, man.
What?
You should have just not said anything for a while and just let them pile up and then unleashed it upon the world. It's like this massive long play.
Even if he doesn't say it, we get people on Twitter just tagging him into stuff and like everybody's retweeting it. So like word gets out that it's tractor stuff. Yeah.
But what is he going to do? Not take Q&A? Like, that's the best part of it. Like, he can't escape it. He does Q&A for half his content. So what is he going to do? Not answer dumb fucking questions? Then he can't have anything to talk about.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
That's how we destroy Phil. You just ask him too many dumb questions, and his brain just short circuits, and he goes back to playing video games.
The best. It's the best op. I love this op.
Yeah, it's great. Anything that's just kind of silly like this is brilliant. Like, you know, it's really harmless.
I just saw the corner of my eye. I have the Phil stream up here. Phil is shaky. Oh my god!
Oh my god! Yeah, I saw it too.
Oh shit!
He was shaking the wig. We got a wig shake.
Right. Hang on, because I've got this all ready to go, so we can watch this.
I actually can't believe this shit, man.
Oh my god!
Right. Hang on.
Yes.
By the way, thank you, Sam. I was going to ask, why do we have this up and running on the dashboard we got here? But this is why, and is it worth it?
Yeah, come on. I'm glad. Just for this one time, it's worth it. Right, here we go. Yeah. hopefully we can hear this as well.
This is the best.
Oh,
an actual Dunslore treatment.
Why am I not hearing this? There you go. Yeah, you can see it anyway.
Yeah, we can see it. There's the shaking.
Why are we not fucking hearing it?
Dude, Boat Knight, you're correct. That is a hobo jiggling a can. That is the exact. Oh, here we go. We got the audio.
We're 10 bucks away from the tier 1 tips goal. Obviously, the goal would be to hit them today so I can wear my Cloud Strife wig as donated by a fan. Looks like a dead dog. Look how it moves.
Donated by a fan again, of course.
Yep.
It's terrifying. Anyway, we'll see if we hit that today. In the meantime, I need to stand up.
All right. Anyway.
Okay. All right. Thanks, guys. Phil. I bet he expected more than that. I'll tell you that. We're not even at the tier one yet. This is a day one, baby. Come on. What's up? Pick it up. Yeah, you guys got to step telling. It up.
When one minute man's the biggest tipper.
Does he leave immediately after shaking the wig? Because I can see him getting up somewhere.
Oh,
he actually just beg and leave?
That's right. We do the cloud workout.
Where you going?
The cloud workout? Oh, yeah. Very comparable body types there. Is that cloud?
He's not got his jammies on today, has he?
He's business style.
Joggers, wasn't it? Jogging bottoms, whatever you call them. Sweatpants.
Sweatpants. He got the sweatpants.
Yeah.
Those are the body fluid receptacles.
Yeah. Anyway, we're all just staring at Phil, and everyone's just staring at
us.
Gone.
So. Yeah.
We're just staring at an empty chair.
A typical DSP play, which is the beg and leave. It's like the pick and roll in basketball. It's like an essential part of every strategy.
Beg and leave. Bob and weave, the beg and leave. Nice. Great strat. Oh, he's back. He's button shirt, crispy. Very crispy.
We should just be reacting to this stream. I should just have it on in like a corner and just let it go.
We're getting up again. Hang on.
Hang on. Here we go. Everyone else can see it now.
Get the fuck out of here. Yeah, he's leaving an hour early too, I believe. That's the play because he has something behind the scenes.
Sure.
Because he started an hour early, so it's all just moved.
You can't play a hype game longer. Of course not. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you?
Shall we go back to the messages?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do that.
We just restream, yeah. Be fun though, but
it would. Right, let's hear from Fiscus.
Hey everyone, Fiscus. I hope you're all well. If the hosts are okay with it, I would like to do a little bit of a fun little exercise, so to speak.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Do you know on Game of Thrones how Daenerys had all those titles that all sounded ridiculous? I would like to do the same to Phil. So, for example, I would go, all hail Philip Burnell, King of Hate, Enlarger of Cat, Father to Agent 2K Lil J Declawed, Haver of Gout, and things like that. I mean,
yeah, okay.
You guys come up
I got
with
the point.
I don't know, but I just thought that would be kind of funny. Anyways, I hope everyone's well and take it easy.
All right, that one is one for chat because they can write it out. We can't think. I can't think that fast, at least. That's there's a good choices. Haver of Gout is a good one.
Yeah, we got the possessor of business degrees, the excellence certified. We got the
Sultan of Scopely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Put the question of the day, Sam. Come on, get that going.
Okay.
I can set it up.
Please do.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Banner of Trolls, yes. Holder of the Banner of Trolls.
I just saw Jester of JPEGs. I like that.
Jester of JPEGs. Sayer of Slurs. Oh, that's good too, Toad. The Haver of Family.
I like that one. Right.
Devourer of Gin, Emperor of Bag. Yeah, put the question there. That we'll read that at the end. Remind us to do that, please.
How should I phrase this? What's DSP's? Because like the people that are tuning in later, they're gonna have idea what I'm talking about.
What's DSP's ? Mother of Dragons name?
Good one.
Yes.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't have known how to phrase that. Anyway, who should we hear from now? This is Noxide Phil.
I guess Dasher of Doors is also
nice. Nice. See, that's what we're looking for.
These all seem hard to beat now, but let's see what you got. Okay.
Poisoner of Ants. I like that. The Ant Annihilator.
Yeah.
Right. The wellness bringer of woodland critters. All right, come on. Let's go.
Let's go.
Okay.
Narkside Phil.
What's up, fellas? This is Narkside Phil on Twitter. And basically, Mirka has been holding on to my bars and his DMs like it's the Golden Wu-Tang album, like he's Martin Shkreli or some shit.
Did I?
I'm about to put these out myself.
Oh.
Yo. These bars are for Phil, and they're straight off the top. I lied. They're written. Here comes Tyrone to give your wife some of his cut. Pause. You see, between you and me, Phil, there's only one man. You're fat, ugly, and gouty, and I'm fantastic like Sam. Shout outs to my brother. He's known as the Mirror Cat. The fuck is wrong with your makeup? Are you using a Mirror Cat? Steve of the Dead? Let's speak of the dead. T. Carter. I wish it were Philip instead. Whoa. With that being said, how many dents does it take to equal a normal-sized head? Without money, your messages go completely unread. So come on, iced coffee. Cough up the bread.
Yeah.
Nice.
I remember this. But what happened with this? Yeah, Guys, please message me in the DMs. I have no idea which DMs this was left in, but this fire.
Hey, Meerkat, you've hoarded those bars for far too long.
Yeah, I'm taking over the music equivalent of space.
Big ups, Ramen Brahman says that the Druckmann rant was his attempt to dip into politics. That being said, isn't it amusing how he could be gaslit into anything if you berate him enough? Absolutely. Was it a political style rant?
No, it was the most basic shit. He doesn't like wokeism in video games. Neither do I. So he just said a bunch of generic shit that everybody else says and thinks he's super smart about it.
And then, of course, I love everyone. I love everything.
I just want everybody to be happy. Oh, no. He actually says, I hate this guy. He just admitted he hates him. That's what I'm saying. It's a good rant. Go check it out.
All right. Well, definitely will do.
Wow.
Because it's he assumes that Neil Druckmann basically had nothing to do with the development of the games, and he just thinks that the guy is going around just blowing his own horn and flexing, when I think he was, he was participating in those games and everything else. But yeah, anyways, go check out the rant. Very funny.
Okay. On to the next one. This is Killjucker.
Hey, that being said, when the suggestion box was first implemented by DSP, I don't really remember anyone in his chat or anything like that requesting it. So I thought it was actually pretty surprising when he first was just requesting constructive criticism and stuff like that. And especially when he first made his post on the community page, he actually approved a lot of comments that I would never have thought would make it through.
Yeah.
So personally, I was actually kind of worried that he was going to maybe actually take the constructive criticism and turn into a somewhat normal streamer, at least as much as he could be. But then obviously when he actually started going over them, it basically just turned into the usual debunking routine that he goes through. So I was kind of wondering what maybe your guys's first initial impressions when he came up with the suggestion box, how it ended up turning out, and wondering if the suggestion box even has a place in the future. Pretty much every single time he gets a suggestion, it doesn't mean anything. All right, thanks.
Good question.
Good question.
Some good thoughts. The thing is, sometimes you catch yourself being surprised by him, but you've always got to remember that he can always play. He can use something like this to play the sympathy card, or have a rant about detractors, like we got the other day with the whole Antley suggestions, which were legit great, comments and ideas. But obviously, he just that went the way of all of these suggestions, which is just how can I dismiss each and every one of these, and again it, as well as all that, it gives him something to talk about, which he doesn't otherwise have anything to say about anything. So it's just something else where he can linger on talking about himself for as long as possible, basically.
This whole feedback loop with him is something that companies do, and they do it sometimes in exactly the same performative way that he does it, to pretend, and it's a whole theater. It's just, we're pretending that we're open to feedback. Is like when gaming companies have an open beta for a video game, they tell you, man, give us your feedback, we're gonna fix everything, and then they don't fix shit. It's the same thing. It's the illusion that he's doing something, that he's taking your feedback, and since he's so open to your feedback, you should also be open to supporting him, because you can see how hard of a worker he is, how much he cares about your experience. So much so that he opens a suggestion box where you can say whatever you don't like about his streams and he's going to fix it, on theory. Because, I mean, not all feedback is good and it's worth it, but at least people try to give him some. The one that Ann Lead gave him, which is very, very detailed and very constructive and very politely phrased, was great. And he shot it down and he actually called him an idiot at some point because he dared to say that there was like sexual LARPing in DSP's chat, which there actually was.
Actually,
and
is.
There is proof of. Yes.
Yes. And there is. Really, it's interesting too because OP Boone responded to Ann Lee as well.
Yes.
And said, I agree with these points. I think these are good points. I hope Phil takes these seriously.
Does that mean OP Boone is an idiot by extension? The guy that Phil respects greatly?
You can't get rid of OP Boone because OP Boone is the comment section. If you lose OP Boone, that's half the comments gone.
The thing is,
you can't lose him.
Well, Phil likes OP Boone's AI comments. Like, you know, maybe he, you know, he's not quite as fond as the actual person, I would imagine.
Yeah, you know. He's like that asshole worker. Like, you don't like it, but like he does it. He does good work. Yeah. So you're like, all right, we put up with it, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But I think it's just
everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, like, no, who, that's true.
Which one of the actual cucks that dedicate time and effort to him does he actually like?
I know, no one. Like? He doesn't. He has no. He. This is a person again. We're saying with 0.0 friends confirmed. He says this. It's not like we're making a joke about him. He says this. So if you don't have any friends in the world, you might want to, you know, think about something. Think about how you're conducting your life. I think it's just though in the end. What I think about this is it's just the checklist of things to say he did this year to improve, right? So these are the things I did, all right? I got the LED lights. Look at this. We've got the new great decorations. Look, I'm wearing a nice, crispy shirt. And also, I had a suggestion box. This is all great things. It doesn't matter that he didn't take any of the suggestions. I had a suggestion box. Come on.
Yeah, it all fits into this whole thing about, you know, he likes to talk about, well, as I said before, his content is about his content. And this is a great example of that, where he gets to just sit and talk about the state of the stream, basically, you know, like where we're at kind of thing and all that kind of thing. Well, never actually doing anything with it. And, you know, and the list of things that he's actually done becomes more and more kind of stretched thin, you know, like a, like whatever you call it, I don't know. It's to the point where it's like, yeah, this is all just like really like basic surface level stuff that like anyone does in their spare time, like when they're not streaming. It's just like, you know, where's the actual improvements?
And I think Sam, you called this the whole thing about his content being about his content a while ago, and it wasn't as bad as it is nowadays. Nowadays, you can just watch a pre-stream on any day that doesn't have gaming news, and it's just about his content. What he's going to do, what he's done, what he wants to do, maybe.
Yeah.
What chat tells him to do, and all that other stuff is just like 2 hours of him talking about stuff that is going to happen or has happened or may not or may happen. It's just worthless.
We get all the possibilities. We get all the future. We get all the past possibilities, current possibilities, what we could be doing, and future possibilities. And he had to explain all those. He's like that. Yeah. What's the guy at Marvel that does that? That knows all the outcomes, whatever his name is. The guy that can see all the...
Bob Iger? Well, kind of.
The guy that...
Dr. Strange.
He's like that. Yeah. He goes back in time and sees all the things he could have done, all the current things he could be doing, and all the things he might do in the future, and then tells them all. And then he'll go like, all right, so next Thursday after this one, we could be doing Halo 4, but I don't know about that yet. It's like, come on, man. That's 2 weeks from now.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to make this video at some point because I have been talking about it since we started this stream. What is it, getting over 2 years ago now? But I have 2,000 words written. I wouldn't call it a script. It's more just kind of notes, and it gets longer and longer and less like cohesive as time goes on. Because like you say, Meerkat, there's more and more building up over time, and the streams are becoming more and more about that. And like I've said before, like there's more than enough streamers that will do this and talk about how you can improve your stream and make it entertaining as fuck, you know. But DSP is very much just,
it's not about, it's not the same thing. It's kind of, how can I waste time? Basically, you know, how can I fill time while making it about myself and making it seem like I'm doing something important? But yeah, it's just finding time to kind of collate it all and make it entertaining somehow. So,
well, we should. This is a good time to get to Gout Gout's February podcast audit.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh, man, that's juicy.
You're our number, man. Go ahead.
Am I doing this? Okay, hold on. Let me pull it up. All right, there we go. Shout out to at, let me get the correct at first and foremost. Well,
DSP Gout. There it is, Gout Gout.
On Twitter. For doing the DSP February podcast audit. Sam, if you can show it, yeah, that would be great because it's like a, it's a pie chart so everybody can see. But I'm going to read out.
I'm on it.
Yep.
So I'm going to start this time around. I'm going to start from the least amount of time taken on something towards the most and try and let people in chat guess what takes up the most time. And it's, you're not going to be shocked at all, but let's play a little game. So first of all, we spend 15 minutes, which is 1%, maybe even less, on exclusive rumors. This has to do with the Xbox going multi-platform, and DSP was really salty about this. He was really salty about people speculating of, about stuff, God forbid, even though he speculates about stuff all the time. Yes. Then we got 26 minutes, which is also 1%, or maybe even less, based on the Baldur's Gate 3 review on the Xbox. I actually have no idea what this is about. He probably had like some half-assed, stupid review.
Yep.
Then, and keep in mind, this is for the entire month that we just had. Then he spent 69 minutes doing an intro, which is 3% of his total podcast. The intro is, I don't know, I guess just like saying that he's DSP and what day it is, and that it's really warm right now.
Hope you're doing well out there today. It's really warm here in the office.
The
you
kind
know.
Of like quote unquote scripted part, the part of the stream that sounds like he's thought about what he's going to say for like 20 seconds.
Then we got 97 minutes of Phil's day off. It's still pretty bearable. It's 4% over the entire month. It's all right. DSP News is at 7% with 144 minutes.
Wow.
Then we got, then now is when it actually gets bad. You think these segments so far were bad, insufferable? At least it was something. Now we get the same thing over and over again until we die. We get the daily rap recap, which he spent 190 minutes on, recapping what he did yesterday.
No, worse than that. Recapping what I talked about yesterday, which was talking about yesterday.
Exactly. Yes.
You have to go one step lower than that. It's not just talking about what I did yesterday. It's talking about how I talked about yesterday.
But it's like, here's the thing, though, because it blows my mind, because the daily wrap is a shorter version of what he talks about on the podcast the next day. So it's not even a recap. You're making it longer than the actual recap.
That's the best.
What? Then
that's my favorite.
Everybody's favorite segment, schedule, takes up 14%. 14%. That's 305 minutes in human time, not even in like dog years or something. then we got the top two. The top two. Try and guess, chat. What are the top two?
First of all, we're at.
Is your favorite segment my favorite segment? The Q&A / wasting time.
That's
That's my favorite.
357 minutes. It's almost 316 minutes the whole month. He spent like fucking hours on this shit. 17%. And then, first and foremost, you might think, so far the percentage has been low. We've been around like, what, 56%? Well, you're fucking right. Because guess what he did for the most time this month? He did DSP Business, which is, you know, content about his content.
You know.
Begging. And I guess shout outs.
Yes, begging and shout outs. Yep, it's begging and shout outs. That's the correct. Yes.
Which is 44%, which is almost three times bigger than the Q&A and time wasting, legitimately. Unironically, this is what his podcast legitimately consists of. And shout out to DSP Gout Gout for the summary. Yes. You can see it on Twitter. You can see the pie chart. You can see everything. This is real science right here. None of that bullshit.
I was going to say, could someone bring this up with the next suggestion? I just want to see what he says to this. 16 hours almost of begging and shout outs. Double, almost triple the number two most time spent segment. What
which
podcast
is also on, shout outs, yeah,
which also
which
shout
is,
outs
is like a Q&A. Yeah.
What podcast on earth would be proud to say that's what their schedule was like? And he wants to call this a big podcast, right? So I want someone let's get that in the next suggestion box, please. Please consider. Please consider that 44% of your podcast is begging and shout outs for said begging, that when it was fruitful begging.
And the thing is that he is making people do this kind of math because of how stubborn he is, how pig-headed he is in his ways. Because people told him, cut down on the fucking begging, cut down on the whole business shenanigans, the Q&A bullshit, on the daily rap recap. Cut that shit out. He doesn't want to do it, so people start taking track of how much time he's actually spending on each segment to prove to him that it's bullshit, to prove to him that it's obsolete and that it's unnecessary. Because that's... You know, I appreciate pettiness in this kind of regard when you want to show somebody something, so you got to go extra petty. This is how you do it. This is fantastic.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I think the most telling one of those is the Q&A is the second most, the second longest part of his content or his podcast, at least, is like an unscripted kind of time filler. That kind of says it all, to be honest. But what I'm particularly interested in, I don't know if it exists. I've scrolled back through Gout Gout's Twitter feed to see if he did one for Jan, because I'd like to know if that's increased, you know, in a month's time.
He definitely has it. He definitely has it. We should check that. That's a good idea.
Yeah, they're not in like pie chart form, but they're like, you know, there's
okay. Tweets. That's how it is.
January podcast audit part one.
Let me get the
that should
Q&A,
be it.
17%. It's exactly the same. That's amazing.
Oh, that is actually impressive.
Yeah.
He's so like settled into that schedule. It's the same exact percent.
Nice. Do you know what? The top one's the same as well, 44%.
Oh my
business,
god.
Begging and shout outs.
That's wild.
That's crazy, man.
That's how locked in he is.
Yeah. Wait.
That's kind of like a teacher who knows exactly when class is supposed to end, so they pace their whole class exactly like it's supposed to be, so it can end on time. He's the same thing with wasting fucking time. He knows exactly how much time to waste on any specific thing. It's amazing. Crazy. It's actually, like, imagine becoming good at being terrible at your job. Like, he elevates this shit to an art form. He's like the artistically shitty streamer. Like aggressively shitty to the point where it's like impressive.
Yeah, it's. We shouldn't give him too much credit because what he does is terrible. But at the same time, it's kind of you can't help but be impressed by the rigidity of what he does. You know how structured it almost comes across when you look at it like that. It's crazy.
He's aggressively dedicated to doing as little work as possible. That's the best way to say it. He's committed to the game. He's on that grind set of doing as little as possible. I don't know if that's possible, but that's what he does.
Yeah.
Big ups, DSP Gout Gout, by the way.
Yeah, man. Really appreciate this.
Because we could all say, like, you do too much. Like, people could say, of course, like, oh, you did too much time on Q&A or too much time on the schedule. And he'd be like, what? I have to do that, guys, whatever. But if you bring the numbers to that next suggestion tab, he can't. He'll probably just ignore you, I guess, because what can he do? He always ignores shit he has no answer for, so.
Yeah.
But, I mean, how long is he going to ignore the whole issue with the podcast being too long? Because you look up one of those suggestion tabs and one of those comment sections of videos where he has talked about it. Everybody unanimously agrees, his own fans, that the podcast is too long and is just bad and it's boring.
Yep.
And his response is that he's doing it long as fuck as possible because he makes the most amount of money then. And also a bunch of bullshit about how his schedule can change, et cetera, but that's not really the actual issue. The reason why he's doing it is because he makes the most money during the podcast. I'm sure if you open up his stream right now, look at a tips goal, it's not going to be changed much from when the podcast actually took place.
Yep. I think that's why we're kind of getting towards, you know, DSP politics and all that shit. Cause he's kind of like, well, gaming's not my thing anymore. Clearly, this is not bringing home the bacon. I get most of my money on that. How can I stop doing the thing that gets less money? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So that's where, if I just talk more, then people get more money. That's what he's thinking. Yeah. You know it. That's not how it's going to work out, though.
maybe. Well, here's the thing. He can always dive into the whole, like, anti-woke crowd and audience of viewers because there is that audience. But the problem is that those people that talk about it, they actually keep track of media. They watch those shows. They watch those movies. They know what is wrong with them. While DSP has none of that experience. He has none of that interest, but he wants to be kind of there because they get views. And the thing is that it's just not going to work out for him if he tries to. But I think that's going to be the perfect spot for him because he can just say a bunch of shit and say that it sucks and people are going to like him just because they're looking for like confirmation bias. But then he is super uninformed. He is super ignorant. So not a bunch of like actual substance.
That whole crowd, they just talk about the same things. It's like, if you want to search about a topic about that shit, there's like 18 channels that do it. Every day they do the same. It's just the toilet bowl rolls and rolls. Everyone talks about the same shit. But DSP is not in those like crowds. And I'm not thinking, guys, you think one Minuteman's going to stick around for that shit? I mean, maybe he might because he's fucking dedicated. But I mean, you think those fans are going to stick around for that shit? I think they do like funny DSP. You know, like, not funny. You know what I'm saying? DSP comedy. How can he add comedy to that shit? He can't. He can barely do it for games anymore. His comedy is, look at that thing. That's what his comedy is now.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he couldn't cut it because, like I said, he doesn't know shit about it. Because those people that talk about him, and I've watched them for a long time in the past, they know all the movies that have come out that they don't like. They know exactly why they don't like them. They have very specific complaints. They actually care about the stuff. While he doesn't give a fuck about anything. He cares about not doing gaming and doing whatever the fuck else.
Yeah. I mean, this goes right along with everything else he's tried his hand with in the last year or two, where it's like, oh, React stuff. That's nice and easy. I'll do that. That'll bring in the money. And then it's, you know, 200 views on a video, and the same with the throwback stuff or everything else. There's a bit, like you say, LT, there's a million other people doing the same things 10 times better than he ever could dream of, with production value, with passion, with knowledge, with, you know, with things to say,
with friends too.
And with they'll sit and have a natural conversation about something and not just exactly what we're looking at now on stream, because I've got him up on screen now. Because
we're waiting for the shaking of the lure.
Yeah, yeah. We're watching his camera now. Fuck it, we're doing it. Anyway, what was I going to say? In terms of how it looks and how it comes across, it's going to be no different to anything else he does. It's the same background. It's the same, you know, uninformed twat sitting there. He, you know, it's not different enough. You know, I don't think anything he does is going to get him the results that he feels he deserves. Even if it is being opinionated about a controversial topic, all he can hope for is being clipped out of context and getting shared around on social media. You know, in the way that he does when something goes wrong on his gameplay streams, it'll just be the same stuff with that.
Go ahead.
Do you want this type of stuff with the demographic that the political content appeals to?
Yeah,
because they're gonna rip him a new asshole. It's not like the gaming people that look at him and be like, oh, like this guy has shitty takes about gaming, he sucks at Legend of Zelda, let's make fun of him. Those people gonna fucking rip him apart, man.
I hesitate to make this comparison because they are two different species, I think. But Maximilian, dude. Right, he started as a fighting game content creator. Right, it's all he was doing for, and he obviously was a legend at it. Got a huge following from that. But now, because he did things based on his passion, now he's also this Final Fantasy VII dude, and he's gotten 40,000 people watching his stream. When Phil has what, 400 now? That's literally 1%. That is literally 1%. When we say level one now, it's level 1% of what Maximilian do.
This we realized before the stream, man. Yeah. It's great. This percentage thing's all time. It's amazing. Yeah.
Like, because following his passion, not following money, following what his passion was. And I bet when Maximilian Dude first played the Final Fantasy VII, a lot of his fans were like, what are we doing? What?
Yeah.
What is this? And I'm sure some people fucking dipped. But when you have passion for something really, and you're not just chasing money, like those fucking reacts are, and throwback is, people can tell that.
Yes.
People can tell authenticity. That is what is currency on the internet these days, especially.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly it. Yeah, because one thing that Max does incredibly well, and people will hang off his every word, is telling his story. Whether it's Final Fantasy VII or anything else you choose, people will sit and listen to that guy talk about his relationship with the game, you know, how he grew up with it. They'll watch him play it five times. There'll be clips of it. There'll be edited highlights of it, you know, and people will rewatch his stuff relating to that. And whereas DSP, on the other hand, will devote a whole stream to talking about his relationship with, like, let's say the FromSoft games, a whole week was it before Elden Ring came out? We had Elden Week, and it's just the most dog shit. Like, you know, there's no authenticity, no passion there. It's just, you know, I played this in 2015, and it was, do you remember when I raged at it? And that's it, you know. But with Max, it's like there's a whole history there. He met the devs and, you know, and all this kind of stuff. So, yeah.
It's no comparison. You cannot compare those two people.
No.
It's impossible. They are incomparable. Watch, if either of you don't care about Final Fantasy or Street Fighter, watch Maximilian do for 10 minutes and you'll see someone that cares about what they're fucking doing. And you can see how they got a massive fan base of whatever the fuck they do. He can play whatever the fuck he wants now. He can be a real variety streamer.
Yeah.
You know?
Exactly. Jew Messiah, about Matt, he's commented saying Max played a hype video on his journey with FF7 last night before he started playing Rebirth. Yeah, watch that. It is great. It's like an update of the... he did Journey to the Remake, which was everything leading up to Remake, you know, and all the announcements, the kind of... you know, will it, won't it, and then it, you know, the long lead up to that, and then this one now is like the lead up to this second part that's come out since and everything since that, and it's amazing. And that exactly sums up what I'm saying, is that, you know, you want to know the guy's history as well as sit and watch his playthroughs, you know. And whereas DSP kind of forces that on you, you know, and makes you wait for this stuff, but it's not like he's building hype. It's just like, can you just get to the game now, please?
Yeah.
I'm bored of
what does he know about? What stuff does he know about? Yeah. Restaurant prices, Misery Merchant says. Yes, he knows about restaurant prices, and that's it. And fighting game history, which we've heard 1,000 times now, because he doesn't live life either. To know about stuff, you have to do stuff. That's kind of how it works.
Yeah.
To learn things, you have to do things. And that's where we also fell short in DSP's life plan. Now he knows about an office and how, I was going to say he knows how blinds work, but he doesn't even know how that works. He has to pay to get those fixed. So
we have a, what we do have a we know? Update, by the way.
Yo, yeah, he's about to.
Yes!
He's showing it again.
Yes! Let's fucking go.
What's happening? Has someone tipped? Oh yeah, he's at 55 now. Okay.
Oh well, 55. Hell yeah. No, that's why. See? Got 55 and have to start shaking, you know? 55? That's a good start. You guys want this? I'm not dunce luring though. Nice. Hell yeah. Oh, we love these wig shakes. We're up to 2 week shakes. Let's get our wig shake counter going.
So is he streaming? He's streaming all day then. Is this kind of almost like a marathon or what?
No, break, break and the night stream. Break and night stream.
But it's this game all day though. Yeah.
Oh, I'm doing the restream of night stream, by the way. So I'll be with Andrew tonight.
Really starting to think he's not going to get much past this, basically the demo of this game. He's still on chapter one. And it's all stuff you could play in the demo and skip now that the game's out. So anyway. Yeah, but he's got to do the full thing and give you the whole full experience.
Context. Yeah, you want the context, dude. Come on.
Right, message anyway.
Yes, let's go.
Here's one from somebody called, quite aptly, I think, Save the Business. Oh, hang on. It's doing that
turn
thing
the mic
again.
On. Yeah, turn the mic on. All right.
A day in the life of a rolling 20 clip. I'm just a stubborn type of fella with a head like a brick. And just because I sit more wet, they say that I'm hopeless. But I don't give a fuck, so blame it on the lowness.
I'm tired of this fucking bullshit. And you know what? You know what? I'm done with it now. All right, we start off today with pimping my wife. So that's okay if you want it. Do it. Fucking do it. Do it. Fuck my wife. Oh, by the way, if you want the same exact features you already had, you have to pay extra. I raised around $96,000 with my wife. Pimping missions was very successful when it came to entertainment value. And spread the cheese money for weeks. Thanks for the money, dummy.
Oh. Yes, I love it. No, bits. I love bits. Yes, I love bits. That was awesome. So much.
What do we got to do? What is you guys' constructive feedback? So yes. You can send us more bits. We need more bits
back. Come on.
The bits were so fucking good. We miss Alex Jones. We miss the DSP airplane type of shit. Man, were the goddamn.
The problem is,
bangers.
Like, rightly so, all of these talented people that used to send bits in have now become creators in their own right. Uh-huh. That's the problem.
That's the problem. They get their own channels. Those assholes. Stop making your own channels.
did we play the Brad Burnian bit?
Oh shit!
We still haven't played.
Oh, play
it?
That! Play that now!
Yeah,
play it. We've been sitting on Brad Burnian for months now.
Let me give him an official apology.
Yeah.
So the whole thing was Brad Burnian. This is for you specifically.
Yes.
That we wanted to play it day one when it was supposed to premiere, but the thing is that it started premiering once we went live, so couldn't do it. We couldn't do it live. And we wanted to do it at the end of the show. Then we forgot, and then we kept forgetting until now when we remembered.
But we remember now. That's the key point.
Hell yeah, brother.
Yes.
Yeah, now I'm trying to find it.
We eventually did direct capture, but it just took us a few years. Same thing. You know. You understand that.
Okay. All right. Give me a
second. I'll be right back.
Yep. Now there's a lot of pressure now, Brad Burnian. People are expecting.
It's live on his YouTube channel now.
Yes, I get it. Hold on, I got it.
Okay, you do that. So, DSP currently making his way through the Nibelheim flashback here. I'm not going to do that. That's ridiculous.
Oh, yeah, do the flashback. You know everything. Come on, show your skills.
Okay. Let's have a look.
Oh, Brad, send me the link on Discord if you could, Brad.
Oh, I've lost the thingy. Oh, well, never mind. Should I play another message while we're waiting?
Yeah, well, hold on. We talked it up a lot now.
Oh, okay.
Brad's on, he said. Okay. Brad's on. Let's watch DSP's awesome gameplay. What do you think of the yellow indicators where to jump, Samuel, as a big fan of Final Fantasy VII?
I don't have a problem with it. Someone could have come along and marked those out on a wall, like, you know, someone that knows the area could have said, yeah, here's a good place to climb. I think that's fine. I think that's perfectly fine.
Yeah, that's what I say. People crying about too much. Yeah. It'd be cool if you had an option to turn it off, I guess, but it's like, whatever.
Yeah, people are just hyped for this game and want to talk about it in any way, whether it's positive or negative.
Big ups, Ibiga, for the raid. Ibiga. Have you ever punched an Ibiga?
Right, how are we looking?
I got it.
Okay.
I have acquired it. I've acquired the package. Package incoming. It's a large package, very large. Send it. It's engorged.
Better be good now, Brad.
It's bursting.
Made this all about you.
You derailed the whole show.
We're gonna stop the stream. You derailed it. We asked for bits. Brad Burnian sent us a bit months ago. Now we're pissed at Brad.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Okay, right. It's coming.
There we go. Hell yeah.
Yeah, right. Let's do that. And let's make sure I can see it on here. Perfect. Right. Brad Burnian, everybody. Oh, no, I can't see it on here. Hang on. Hang on.
We'll get there. Give me a second here.
What's going on? Something's going on with my OBS.
OBS problem.
I remember this shit was so good the first time, man. It was like, these are, they're so, I don't know how to say this. They're so infuriating in this specific DSP way. He manages to capture the whole energy like perfectly. Uh-huh. Like I'm actually pissed off watching this, but I'm waiting for the thing to start. Yeah. And it's just like fucking DSP. It fucking sucks.
Like he's not trying just enough, you know. But yeah, I know he is doing a lot of trying to make it look that authentic, but it works. All right, ready, Sam?
Like he got it. He got the idea, the concept.
There it is. For some reason it wasn't showing on the stream.
He's a method actor.
It's there now. Right. Ready, finally. Here he is.
There we go.
Well, thank you very much, guys. Thank you for hitting the lights goal. Yeah, nice to hit it again. I know I've got the pinwheel last time, and yeah, loads of people, you know, tell me, you need to do the pinwheel. I've done it this time, so just, it's done now. But yeah, good timing, because we've reached the end of the page one podcast. So we can get some Q&A in before we get to the main poetry stream. So if you have any questions for me, you know, just put them in the chat, and I will answer them.
That's the best.
thank you very much. Thank you for the compliment on the shirt. I got it out for the summer events, the Brad React Damn It summer events, and people seem to like it. You know, they like the shirts I'm wearing. Like I was dressed differently. I washed my hair. I washed it, and people seem to like it. So if you guys like it, then I guess I'll wash, and put on a shirt. That's. Seems the thing to do, isn't it? Enjoyed. Thomas.
Shout out Thomas. Thomas Doggo. Doggo.
Thomas Doggo.
Shooting some wires down there.
Thomas Doggo.
Dog.
Shout out Thomas.
But thank you for the compliment on the shirt. And glad you guys are liking it,
Man, he got it so good. Oh, God.
That face.
No, I did not know that apply for that. Uh-huh. That's an interesting. Yeah, very interesting. Thank you for
do that face.
Telling me that.
Yeah. Leading down.
Do you feel like your content has changed since you began making it? Yes, it's... Yeah,
Siege mode.
I've said this before, publicly. I was very slow to kind of take up some of the things that other content creators make use of in their content. I didn't start streaming and posting to YouTube until early last year. But prior to that, for those that maybe are kind of newer fans, I used to distribute my poetry as a newsletter. Delivered to people via via carrier pigeon. I was behind the times. Other people were saying, YouTube's this great thing. And I was like, I liked how personable it felt. It felt like receiving a letter.
God, that's too good.
From a friend, almost. Not many. I mean, not many of them did get there. The pigeons I had were not. I don't think they were trained. I don't think I ever saw. I never saw them again. Actually, I think I got five, and they all went. So I guess, I got there eventually. Yeah, well, we're here on YouTube now.
The buzz. Listen for the buzz.
And I guess the other thing that I'd say is in my early poetry days, I would write a lot of kind of sexual, kind of style content in my poetry. So I was young, I was immature. I've changed now. I say, it's been a whole year since I started that stuff.
God. What I would do is, I didn't want, you know, my fans at the time to feel uncomfortable with all the, you know, the sexual.
He's not saying anything. It's so good.
Is that randomly, what I would do is, when I was reading the poetry, I would just out of nowhere scream a racial slur to connect it, so it wasn't, to make it less uncomfortable.
Okay.
You know, it kind of just take people by surprise, and they would suddenly just forget, like, oh, it was, you know, sex stuff. Like, so, you know, but you could, I mean, you know, you, back then, you know, a year ago, you could do that. You know, that's, people were fine with that. Nobody complained. You know, but now, you know, in, you know, 2024, you can't just, you know, can't just shout, you know, racial slurs anymore. You know, and, you know, even as, you know, just as a joke, obviously, you know, you know.
Wild West.
Because of the fucking idiots. You know.
Wild West days of poetry.
Time, I have changed for the better. So yeah. All right, so it's gone quite, you know, it's a lot of changes. So kind of.
Wow.
You know, yeah, I mean, it got really only started because of, you know, the trolls that would, you know, attack me and my content. You know, that they were bringing stuff up. You know, they got me kicked out of, you know, Teespring, you know, with my mugs. I had, you know, my mugs with, you know, BRD poet T. You can put T, you know, in that. So it's, you know, like a, you know, it's a nice shirt. But, you know, you could not get those anymore. You know,
leg slap.
Because you know, if I threw this pinwheel, you know, probably now there's going to be, that's going to be clipped and be like, oh, he's angry, he's attacking his, oh, he's breaking his stuff, oh, you know, and, you know, it's like, no, it's not that big a deal, you fucking idiots, it doesn't matter, okay, you know, but that's just how it, you know, that's how it is now, you know, no, Clive, the racial slur didn't rhyme, I didn't make that, you know, that's not the point. They weren't a part of the proper poetry. You know, that's not the point. You know, it was just, I say, it was, you know, it's kind of just to get, make it so people, you know, were less uncomfortable with the sexual stuff, you see. So, you know, that was all. It wasn't, you know, it didn't need to rhyme. You know, what can you rhyme with, you know? Yeah. So, yeah. Do we have a super chat? I think we had any, yeah. Oh, we did. Oh, sorry. I must have missed that. I do apologise. Oh, there it is. Yeah. We had a super chat for £5 earlier, so I just just get that on the leaderboards. Oh, I apologise for that.
Turning. Hiss in the background, it makes it.
I don't know if you've noticed the tip goal as well.
Yeah.
The name of the guy.
Yeah.
Mine, yeah, Eager.
Yeah, thank you for that. That's super chat. That's...
No way, man.
Dude, too good, man. That was masterpiece. Masterpiece. I think that was better than the first one.
Yeah.
That was better than the first one, I think.
I think the first one was more infuriating in the whole, like, how bad the fucking pacing is, and it actually pissed you off watching it. This one was more funny, I think.
Yeah. That's amazing, dude. Well, I would please don't stop. That's the only request. You got it perfect, dude. The face looking into the chat for something, you know, like, you got it so good.
I think the next competition we should do is something like this, where you get to make a DSP impression in any way you want. You can try and, like, clone his stream like this. You can try and just do it vocal. You can do it any other way.
Yeah.
I think it's a pretty good idea.
Yeah. I wonder. That actually would be a good idea. Like, would it get draining after a while to hear all the snorts? I mean, maybe, but I think it might be worth it.
That is kind of the point. It's like, who does it technically the worst? You know, who is, like, the most annoying, the most obnoxious, the most punchable guy?
I was just thinking, like, would it be limiting in terms of having to have a camera? But then you could have a slideshow art, you know, slide.
Yeah, that's fine.
Stuff that you've made, like, that's, you know, funny references and stuff like that. So you could do that and just talk
So yeah, I think that's a good idea.
I think because you could be, you could do a lot of stuff, right? You could do the food review. You could do talking to the pre-stream. You could do, you know, banning someone.
Actual
you could
do, gaming.
Yeah, gaming stuff. Yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, that's a pretty good idea actually. All right, well, let's get to Kaching first, and then we'll talk about it. But
I think we try and be pretty open with all the competition formats. So whatever way you want to approach this is going to be, you know, convenient. So just go crazy, just go creative. But first, wait for the Kaching.
Loot box opening. Yeah, that's pretty hype. That'd be good. Oh, sauce making. Can you imagine? Someone got sauce. Oh God.
Do that.
Hotel walkthrough. Oh man.
We got, like, for a fact, we know that there's very talented people out there that can nail a DSP impression. I know Mr. Ludacris recently had his Mr. Beast tasting thing where he took 20 minutes until he actually opened the package. It was the fucking worst thing I've ever watched. It was such a pain to sit through. Then we got Theo with the Dark Side Theo stuff, where it's the same thing. Like, he nails all the mannerisms. He stays in character for like half an hour. I'm sure people are gonna pull it up and it's gonna be fantastic.
Also, Slow Beef has a very famous video from probably 9 years ago now, where he stays in character for like 45 minutes and just it's crazy. It's insane. Slow Beef was a legend.
Forgive me, but the guy as well that did the Welsh guy that did the one that DSP watched when he did the AVGN parody, he presumably could do a good DSP. He could certainly nail it, the visuals.
Oh, the liquid,
Jay
liquid
things.
Fill.
There you go.
Yeah, Jay doing the liquid fill.
Yes.
Just look. You notice that he has less hair than me. That's not a good look.
He's uglier than me.
Yeah.
Like, damn, dude, he was typecast. That's his purpose. To look like you.
Yeah, he was chosen for his look because he looks like you. You do realize that, right, sir? I don't think he does, though. He's a legend, though. Liquid Phil is a hero for millions.
Yeah. And he is now officially certified excellent because he won the Jintro competition.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
Yeah. And he won the certificate of, what was it? Of achieving cinematic excellence. That's what it was.
The ACE certification, yes.
Basically, we just won a whole competition of parodies that Phil wouldn't understand.
Yes,
it would be, and you know, the sort of thing that he may end up watching at some point on his React stream.
I don't think these guys understand parody. there's no jokes there. Like, how is there not jokes there? The whole thing is fucking jokes. You're jerking off on it.
my favorite part of this is, and I wrote it down because I wanted to bring it up, when he said, "I randomly scream a racial slur to make it more comfortable for the audience." That was the best.
That was good, dude.
Yeah, good. Right. We should do a message.
Yeah.
Let's get to it. Yep.
Oh, okay. This guy or gal is called the Wolverine Doll.
Uh-oh. Hey, guys. This is the Wolverine Doll. I've been working hard on more Phil song parodies, and maybe I need a break because my mind is going places it oughtn't go. I only just realized that my mental image of Phil has been replaced with Liquid Phil from the videos Jay doing things.
Oh, wow.
No chances.
Whenever I'm not looking directly at Solid Phil, my mind confabulates his face. So does that happen to any of you guys? Any notable confabulations? Maybe it's just me. Hey, big ups to everybody. Steve, get well soon. I'll send you some Pacific Northwest air in a bottle. That'll fix your back right up.
Hell yeah. Wolverine Doll is the legend that won our parody story fan fiction contest, the Wolverine Doll. Wolverine Doll is a legend themselves.
It was so good, man. Oh my God, that was so good.
Yeah. They had the refrigerator, the Hogans at the end. Yeah. Remember the Hogans?
you got like LTG that turned into an attack helicopter. Like all that shit. Like, what the fuck? How do people come up with this shit, man?
That was the best. That was the best. But yeah, have you ever, when you right on time, that was not rigged. It was just, that was totally organic, dude, that he mentioned Liquid Phil, and you see Liquid Phil instead of the actual Phil. No, I've never had that happen, though, to be honest.
Yeah,
I see the grease.
With like words where I can't hear robust anymore without thinking of this dude.
Yep.
I can't think of like thus, because I mean nobody I talk to says the word thus, because like what the fuck, when do you even see that word? But this dude, he even said it today in his DSP politics segment, like dunking on the Druckmann.
I think, right. There's like, that's there's a few words that are just done. So like devour, robust, thus. For me, it's also helicopter. If I see the helicopter, that kind of comes up sometimes. I always think, you know, like this just, oh God. Those kind of those four.
we got literally four people in a row in chat saying that the phrase "that being said" has been ruined for them.
That's true.
That's,
yeah.
That's actually like, that's brainwashing on our part, because you got to think about us. You don't think about Phil. You think about all the positivity and chill interaction that is happening here. So this is all on purpose.
Bottom line, actually, I get the bottom line too.
This isn't a name that we came up with real quick the day before we actually made the podcast. This has been meticulously crafted to brainwash you in such a way that you only think about us.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. We definitely haven't told everyone that that actually was the case before.
Because it wasn't.
Yeah. There you go. Debunked, bitch.
There you go. People were asking for the Phil cam again, so there you go.
Okay, Phil cam's back up. We're at 55, boys. Save the business.
I got a little bit distracted there because I was watching some of his gameplay and Sephiroth, because you get to control the bad guy in this flashback scene at the start of the game, and Sephiroth actually died in his gameplay. So that I feel is one of the first things you'll probably see in a "this is how you don't play" of this game. Because Sephiroth's a literal god at the start. You know, he's there
massive
to serve
badass.
One. Yeah, his purpose is, apart from story, is to teach you that like this guy is like leagues ahead of you, and he can't die. But he's waving the thing again.
The three prong plan, motherfuckers.
So pathetic, man. I cannot believe this shit.
Dude, we got it. We got the third.
and now that Sam mentioned that "this is how you don't play," there's the first part of the Elden Ring "this is how you don't play" that dropped by The Outsider. Make sure to go check it out. It's like 12 ups, hours fucking long.
Oh my
and
God.
It's so long for a reason. Like, trust me, it's a stinker. It's stinky winky, man.
Meerkat, look, we just got the beg and leave.
I was just going to say.
Move. Oh, the beg and leave. There we go.
Hall of Fame move right here. This is how we got famous. The beg and leave. Hell yeah. He lowered the goal to 100. Base Boglemite. He lowered the goal to 100. Yes. Jeez. Hey, those goalposts. Hold on a second. Let me just move this real quick. Hold on. All right. There we go. I moved the goalposts, guys. Don't worry.
I almost want someone to just wail out $45 right at the end of the stream so he has to put it on for like 2 minutes and then just leave. That would be great.
You know, that's what they do. There's some cuck waiting right now, having his like timer set up to 15 minutes before clock out so he can swing by and see, how much money do I have to add in so we can hit that goal? And then they're going to do it. And then he's going to put on the thing for like 30 seconds. And that's going
to
be it.
I low-key think the chat is revolting. Like, they just want Baldur's Gate. They want to show... They're trying to assert dominance, oddly. Like, we control what you play, bitch. And we want Baldur's Gate. Because you saw those, like, like a Dragon Issue streams. Like, there was, like, three of them that got, like, $5. Like, one tip. And I think they're trying to say, like, hey, I don't give a fuck what you play. We want Baldur's Gate, bitch. And they're just we don't support this shit, you know?
Yeah, there is something... I imagine, I mean, well, we all know what happens. You know, he'll have a bad stream and then he'll do one tomorrow or whatever, and he'll get $300 in a day and everything will be great again. Yep. He'll be clowning in that cloud wig. But something about this game in particular where I'm thinking, like, if this doesn't go well, this could really change things. You know, it really could be a turning point. You know, we could be seeing that politics stream or something.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because there's a lot of, you know, I keep seeing the term egg. He's putting all his eggs in this basket, you know, and it really does feel like that, where it's like, if this doesn't go well, we're not going to hear the end of this, you know.
Because he hates Baldur's Gate. Let's get it straight. Mm, he hates that shit, but he gets it money, so he has to play it.
Yeah. And you know the thing, I don't think people understand how back in the day, and I mean like, let's say 2 years ago, he would straight up have like a super humiliating begging segment, and like under 10 minutes after that, somebody would send him like $50 just to shut him up. This shit doesn't work anymore. This does not fly in 2024. So he's going to get more and more desperate. So by like the summer, we're going to have a new channel that he's going to be shilling. And it's probably going to be DSP Politics, because when he starts talking about stuff like this, you can see he feels very confident about it, as if he knows something that other people don't. And he is really itching to share it with everyone. So it's probably going to happen.
Like he's working on it behind the scenes already with the few denturns, you know, making that the logos and shit.
What I'd like to see first, though, before he goes full on with that, maybe to see a new channel that's just DSP Q&A. That would be the greatest. Could you imagine?
It'd be a battle to the bottom with DSP Throwback.
Yeah,
who's gonna get less views, DSP Throwback or Q&A? I bet Q&A will win, because some of us would watch it for like dented answers, because like there is some gold dust to be found. But that's like Throwback, even we can't handle it for the content.
That's the thing with Q&A. It's almost there for us, you know, because we have so much. There's so much to be mined from that, and so much control that we can take that otherwise you don't really get, because we're contributing to it.
The thing with a lot of that style of content he does, I'm going to make a reference to the React channel. So the React stuff, you either watch it live on somebody's restream, talking about the trolls, or you just watch when somebody clips it. I don't think people go to his channel to see like, wow, I wonder if this segment is going to be funny, and then you play one of the videos.
Yep.
It's more like it's either somebody restreaming it, you check him out, you have your laugh as it goes along, or you just check up, you know, one of the clip channels on the other day. So those channels don't get views off of trolls.
That's true.
The Throwback channel doesn't get views off of trolls, because it's just recycled shitty ass old content. And the good stuff, which is him reacting to something and just like backpedaling on all the jokes and making a bunch of disclaimer statements, that happens and people clip it. So you don't have to go watch that shit.
Yeah, that's like, really true, actually. Like, the only time I ever really kind of venture to his channel is when I'm actively trying to find like the best quality version of a certain clip, basically. You know, it's not to actually seek out something for any long period of time. It's like, you know, if I need something for a video or whatever, it's like, you know, there's the best version of it, because I'm that, you know, I'm that much of a perfectionist. But yeah,
it's like, even his retro reacts where he's there, like the views of that, he can't get 1,000 views on those. He's got videos 3 days old that can't get 100 views on that channel. Cause that's this, no one can survive that. No one, his fans don't like it. No way. You know, that's amazing. DSP Throwback has to be, I mean, I didn't expect it to be that bad, but no one gives a fuck about this channel. No one.
Yeah. I think even the people that actually care, they check out his live stuff when he's like nostalgia baiting people. It's like, whoa, come look at me watch my old Heavy Rain playthrough and reminisce on how much better I was living back then. And then they show up, they get him to like $150. It's all good, it's all fantastic, we move on. But they don't actually watch the videos.
It's like, like one weird guy, like, I'm watching Heavy Rain and gave him like $300 or something. It's like, it's so weird. Like, because he's playing a game and reacting very cringily to your old jokes that, you know, he says are very bad, but I just want to give you $300 for that. Yeah, Phil, thanks. And then what about every day? Like, do you like the person he is today or what? You know, it's just a question I would wish we could ask that dude. Like, what do you think about what Phil has become? Are you just throwing something to your past? Like, you know, like, if I was going to support like Spoonie today or something, you know, like, I just don't do that because he's an asshole now. But I mean, you know,
that does make a lot of sense. Would you support him now, even though he is completely different to what you liked about him?
I wouldn't. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like, that was a cool time of my life, and now it's kind of gone, you know, and he's clearly not well. So I don't know. It's just, it's interesting. But I have a hard DSP got him through college in hard times and stuff. Uh-huh. His master's degree, remember?
Yeah.
Got him through his master's degree, dude. All right, Samuel, let's go. We got about 15 minutes left. Oh, did Sam go? Uh-oh.
He's here, dude. Samuel? Hello, I'm fantastic Mr. Sam. I'm British.
I'm British. I'm going to smoke in the fog. Have some tea and crumpets. He's a fucking cunt. He's a cunt.
He's taking the piss, mate.
He's making a schedule.
The Queen of England is dead. rest in peace to the Queen. Governor.
The best band, the best. I like that. trying to think of the band from I could use so many options. Queen's a great band, definitely. Queen, the Beatles.
Queen, yes. The Beatles are great, mate.
Dude.
Yeah. Beatles are banging, isn't it? UK office is better.
It's the Hey Army, bruv.
Oh, why are we doing English accents? What's going on?
I don't know.
Nothing.
We're not. Somebody in chat asked us to do them.
Yeah. Mm. And they also said they want your American accent. They said that too.
Oh, that has to cut. I can't just do it. God damn it.
Your American accent's very, very talented. Well, but all right.
Let's give you a reason. Let's say that you really want to put on the nice little wig that we got going on. How would you say that? How would you beg for it? Beg for it, Sam.
Tell everybody about the wig we have.
I can't. I can't do it under pressure like that.
All right. Well, let it come naturally, organically.
All right.
Yeah. All right. Let's do two more messages that we got to get out of here. Come on. Two more. Hit us with it, Sam. Come on.
Okay. Right. Let's do a recent one. Here it is.
Yeah, please. Come on.
The most recent. Kenny B.
Hey, guys. So lately, Phil's been talking about his blown out back, how his past injuries have been causing it to act up, or he slept on it wrong, or Tyrone blew it out. but I was just wondering, what are y'all's takes on it? Are we going to see like a health arc? Is he going to talk about being sick or injured more? Are we going to have more DSP health related news to try and get more dents to donate? Great work, guys.
This is simply a man investigating and trying to feel around how HealthCoin is priced right now, how we can invest in HealthCoin. He wants to know what to expect. I mean, of course, with DSP, the dude, like, you can point at any one part of his body and there's going to be a health issue there. So, of course, we're going to see crazy stuff happening with him health-wise. If he has to go to the hospital, that's going to be like a cataclysmic level event. That's going to be extinction level threat.
Yes.
Because, man, you know how many bills you got to pay in the U.S. just for going to the hospital. That's a different thing.
When he was sick, I heard this on WPIG today. When he was sick with a normal cold, that one time, not even the most recent time, we're talking about like 4 years ago, he said, people are suggesting I go to the doctors. You clearly don't know how it works in the United States. Even with healthcare, you have to pay $2,000 for a doctor's visit. That is just not true. What do you have healthcare for then? If you pay $2,000 for a visit? It's making it up. So if he went to the hospital now, he'd be saying it's, $50,000. I got to pay $50,000, guys, by tomorrow. Like, let's do a begathon. He'd be saying all that shit.
Damn, $2,000? Who the fuck is your doctor? Is it like Brad Pitt?
He said $2,000. Yeah, he said that number specifically, even with healthcare, which is an absolute lie. Yeah. Wow. If you have health insurance, if you don't have health insurance, all right, now we're talking. You know, even that seems crazy, but you know, it's a lot when you don't have health insurance. But he said he did. But yeah, if he was, it's going to happen. The older he gets, the more it's going to be a thing. He's going to, whatever it takes, everything is a tool to beg for more. So, you know.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Ambulance is right. Okay. Ambulance trip without insurance might be $2,000. All right. Now we're talking. He's talking about going to see a doctor.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, come on. Even I know this is bullshit. And I don't even know the first thing about American healthcare, except that it's not very good. But, you know,
it sucks. But what do we do?
Yeah. What I wanted to ask you guys is, do you guys think Kat still has a job or not? Since we got the day off yesterday, there wasn't any problem with it. And Kat seems to be at home all the time playing video games, chilling, maxing, relaxing. She wanted to play the Final Fantasy game, but she doesn't have a PlayStation.
Was there any other like clues towards that? Because I'm sure someone mentioned that a week or two ago as well. And I don't know if I've like missed something.
Here's the Theo theory.
Okay.
I think it kind of, since clearly it seems like, you know, Trident Cat out there was not for Mike Klum. I think that kind of theory has died. It wasn't about Mike Klum. I thought it was, but it seems like that's not the case anymore. But maybe she was either quit her job or was let go from her job. And now
Phil kind of talked her into, hey, you can do streaming with me, honey. We can get some extra income this way. And that's kind of why Kat agreed to it, because it was like a side gig kind of style thing. You know what I mean? Mm. Like, we can get increased money. If you do that, it'll make up for the money we're missing, you know, because what's the best she could make if she's working 3 days a week? $300 a week, let's say. You know what I mean? So on a stream, they get $150 when she was there at the beginning. You know what I mean? So I think it could, that's just my working theory right now. But I don't think she's working anymore now.
Fucking hell, man. She needs to pull her weight if that was the thinking. Like, if that was, if that was,
she got a lot of weight to pull.
Sorry,
easy, I knew it.
Poor choice of words. It was completely intentional.
Easy.
But yeah. Like, she, if that was her best sort of performance in terms of, like, you know, what she has to offer on a stream, especially that last one where it was like where she disappeared.
Yeah.
It's just like, wow, man, you need to actually step it up somewhat, yeah. I would think.
If she's putting much effort at work as she is on the fucking DSP stream, then,
like,
I mean,
you can see why she would get let go. She has been evicted in her past. I mean, that's a fact. That's public fact. She was evicted somewhere too for who knows. I mean,
well, yeah, we don't know the details. Could have been anything.
Could have been anything. But I mean, let's just say I don't think she has the ability to live by herself and pay her own bills. I don't think she has the ability to do that with her mental state. I don't know. Who knows?
She seems perfectly capable to work a job. I don't know why not.
Well, you know, those kind of jobs, you know, who knows how well she's doing. She might be a mess. She can't keep on to the job. She's worked at three jobs since she went to Seattle, right? That we know of.
I don't know.
I know, obviously the jeans one is confirmed.
Yeah.
Wasn't there also the other clothes one? No, the grocery store, right? Kroger, she worked there too. Right, I thought that was confirmed. Was it not? Fred Meyer. Yeah,
sorry.
Fred Meyer was something like that. Yeah.
So if you have three jobs in the three, how long you've been there? 5 years. I mean, you might not be the best worker.
Oh yeah, I mean, that was pretty much confirmed the day the car broke down and Kat just decided to stay home instead of taking the bus because, quote unquote, it wouldn't be worth it for her to go to work.
Yeah,
if people don't rely on her to show up and actually do what she's getting paid for.
Yes. Yeah. I don't think she's the most, the entrepreneurial style girl. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
No.
Or a reliable employee.
Yes, and, let's say that way.
That's the thing. With part-time jobs like this, because she, of course, she works part-time, all you got to do is be reliable. Show up when you're supposed to show up. Leave when you're supposed to leave. If somebody calls you on your off day and they say they need work, it's, you know, extra credit if you show up.
Yes.
But I mean, this kind of stuff, we're like, well, my car broke down, so I guess I'm just not coming to work today. That's just not what they want.
And you all know, we all have been work with people like that. You know who the fuck they are. And then you're waiting for a reason to get rid of them. Just like Phil, you know, like Circuit City, they were waiting for a reason to get rid of him. And he gave them a reason, which was $2.77 of an employee discount. And they said, get the fuck out. Yeah. By the way, Sam, could you rewind? Someone just said we got the fourth wig shake.
We all saw it while you were talking.
Yeah, I was talking my head off. I missed it. We got four. We're up to four, boys. Can we get five in 7 minutes? Let's do one more message. Hope we get there.
Yep. Okay. Here is, in fact, let's hear from 2D2 Will.
There we go.
Not video stats.
Legend.
Hey guys, 2D2 Will here. Remember back during the Turkey Tom stuff where Phil said that he didn't want to go on a podcast to talk drama with Turkey Tom, but he will be willing to talk about stuff like being a YouTuber and how, you know, about his career. I would actually love to do that kind of podcast with Phil, because as this suggestion box stuff has shown, it's the only way to really challenge him and his ideas. He will misconstrued anything that you say if you give it to him in text form in that suggestion box. I would love to just challenge his points, ask him why he can't get a simple video editor. Why does his video podcasts and his reviews have like 20 seconds of dead air in the beginning? And just all these different things that he should be able to do, but he doesn't, because he is a bad YouTuber and a bad streamer. He doesn't basically just challenge him on the fact that he's ruining his content. And it is just awful. So do you think that would make for a good idea if someone could just actually talk to Phil and tell him, you are doing YouTube wrong?
Well, no. Yeah, no. No, he would find it. He would talk his way through those. You know how he does that. You know what? Yeah. He slithers his way out of questions he has no answer for. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for him, the whole suggestion box, he's looking at it from a completely backwards perspective. If you're a public personality, somebody is sending you suggestions, you want to focus on the ones that you're more willing to take.
Yep.
So you can say, you know, hey, my fan base, they got good suggestions. I'm going to take them. I'm going to improve. But he's looking at it from the perspective of, I'm going to take this comment. I will debunk it. I will win this dispute. I will win this argument. And he's ending up just like, you know, taking good ideas, like Ann Leet left him one, and plenty of other people have left him very similar ideas, and he shoots them down. And in the end, he has this smug attitude about how I'm right, and I just told you why I'm right. So stop asking me bullshit like this, which makes him look bad and makes him look like an idiot, and it makes him look like he's closed off to feedback, which is the exact opposite way he wants to make himself seem by doing the whole feedback suggestion box type of thing.
Yep.
I think the fact that it's such a prominent thing within his content currently, that, you know, the whole idea of having a suggestion box, is, it says it all really, because he clearly just wants he wants to be able to sort of talk about himself and show himself to be correct about how he's doing everything, because people have so many suggestions on how he could improve, and it's all quite basic stuff, to the point where it's like, why would you show this on stream and have it be a part of your you know what you're putting out?
Yeah,
you know, surely this is stuff you would take on and go, oh shit, okay, yeah, I'll sort that out for next time. You know, a lot of it is just that. But with him, it's like, it's half an hour of a podcast or whatever it is, you know, and it's not just one day. It's like an episodic thing, you know, every so often he'll bring it up again. And it's like, you know, I think that says it all, about him really.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah. He can't admit he's wrong. He can't admit fault. And if he does, it always, there's something, a caveat to it. Like, oh, that was five years ago. I don't do that anymore. I was wrong then, but that was a long time ago. That was a different person. I was a character. Yeah. You've heard it all. You know, even, well, we got to get to the go ahead. Last comment. And then we got to get to the Mother of Dragons names. Go ahead, Meerkat.
Yeah. Even the really easily debunkable stuff, like the points that he cannot physically argue against, like, you know, the fucking Q&A being too long, recap being too long, schedule being too long. He just decides to deflect and focus on create a straw man argument and defeat that instead. So no, yep. You can't quite possibly cannot reach this guy. He has convinced himself to what is right and what is wrong, and he's just going to keep doing this. This whole suggestion thing, this whole feedback loop thing, it's performative, it's theatrical, so he can extract as much money as possible by pretending to be somebody who actually gives a fuck while not giving a fuck at all.
Yep. And the only people that buy it are the people that are susceptible to, or to enjoy being, that can handle being begged to by their favorite streamer and give money to that person that they're begged for. So that's the level of intelligence we're dealing with. You know what I mean? Like, it works with the people that it works on. It doesn't work with most of the world, but there are a few people that it doesn't work on for whatever reason. And that's who he's, that's his audience, you know? So let's get to the Mother of Dragons names real quick. I'll go through them today if you don't mind. We have Horse Whisperer, the Father of Whales, the Groomer of Panda, the 10-Year Planner, the Beggar of Ages, the Scanner of Chats, the Operator of Households, the Snorter of Snots, the Savior of Sikorsky, the Begmaster of Renton and Pool Lord of Champions, the King of Sways, the Avoider of Taxes, Winner of Fourth Place, Sultan of Snorts, Destroyer of Meaningful Style, Robust Relationships, the Lord of the Lean. I like that. Lord of the Lean. Of course, we got some tea action here. Killer of Tea. The Soothsayer of Woodland Critters.
The Gouter of Crystals. That's low effort, but I like it. The Gouter of Crystals. Master of Sauce. Lover of... Okay, come on. That Lover of Spiders. The Kaching of Ginter... the Kaching of Ginter... Ginterfell. Excuse me. The Kaching of Ginterfell. There we go.
Oh, yeah. And,
yes. The Defamer of Cannons. The Master of Bait. I like that. The Master of Bait. The Almighty Copium Consumer. The Daddy of Derek. Okay. Okay, that's very simple, but gets to the point. The Gout Swayer. Oh, here we go. This is the last one. The Lord of Untested Cats. There we go. The Lord of Untested Cats. Puncher of Bees. Detainer of Dents. The Snorter of Film. And the Keeper of Bags. Philip Burnell is his name. There we go. Big ups, everybody, for that. It was very fun. So
like
new
legitimately
style.
Legitimately, like, actual dozens of these. People went hard this time.
Fucking loads,
Fattener of Cat. I saw a lot of them. I didn't read everyone, but you're all legends. Thanks so much, everybody. Destroyer of DoorDash, Taker of Tips, Lord of Renton, first of his name. All right. Anyways, business style
last
announcements.
Last of his name, maybe even. Bill Burnell.
Hey, oh, last of his name. It's
we're
the right
ending
way.
This right here.
Yes. So Meerkat's going. Where are you, what are you doing to Meerkat? I know you're taking a little vacay here. Let everyone know. Come on. When are you
going to
be back?
I'm going to Turkey next week to Istanbul.
Hell yeah.
I'm going to be gone both days. So that's Sunday and it's Thursday for you. And I'll be back right after that.
Sounds good to me. We'll be in, me and Sam and a special guest will be with you on Sunday. Don't worry about that. Also, restream of Final Fantasy WPIG with Injured Cold tonight. It'll be pretty hype day today. So that's it for today. Samuel, take us home.
Okay. I've not heard this one, so it better be good. But yeah, bye everyone. Big ups.
We ordered from this place called the Habit Burger.
Ah.
That wasn't bad. Yeah.
It was a... Hold on. Play this one. It was great. Hold on. Let me just find it. yeah, it's burgers for dinner.
Okay. Here we go. Burgers for dinner. 2 seconds, everyone.
Hang on. Oh, by the way, Kachiga the Ring at submissions. You have till midnight today. I'll let it go. Midnight today.
Come on, this is going to be really good, everyone.
It's going to be awesome.
Don't you worry. Listen, oh, it's going to be so good. Right,
hopefully
here it
Phil
is.
Gets off another shake. Come on. All right, go ahead. Shake that wig, bitch.
Okay. We decided that we wanted burgers for dinner.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. This one goes out to the one and only, the big cat, the fat cat. Big ups. I first saw you in Burger King. You took 2 seats, 'cause that ass is way too big. Had a boyfriend, I realized, but you told him lies with your raccoon eyes. The DoorDash is here. Wipe away your tears. Got you extra fries, and they taste just right. Have no fear. There's no trolls here. Tevin made.
I actually don't think clicking like on a live stream helps at all. So it really doesn't matter if this stream gets 100 likes or 2. I don't think it affects it.
Raccoon eyes. Tevin made you cry with those raccoon eyes. Take your power walking on the beach, feasting on some sushi like you were a queen. Let me run some errands while you sleep. I can watch you play Skyrim all day this week. Have no fear.
have this day.
Devin made you cry with those raccoon eyes. Devin made you cry with those raccoon eyes.
In reality, like I tell you guys, every day when I wake up, that's the best day of my life. I feel like this next day is awesome. I have a beautiful wife who I love so much. She loves me and a family, Jasper. You know, the things we get to do together, you know, I definitely want more time with them and more family time, but I absolutely love my life today compared to how it used to be. Seriously. All those years back then, you'd be like, it's a whirlwind of crap. It was me. And by the way, I've told you guys about my past. I used to drink way too much. I would be drinking constantly all the time because I was so stressed out. Honestly, when I started with this whole thing, I was depressed many years ago, you know, a decade ago. I didn't like my life or anything. And basically, liquor was the way to kind of get through that. You know, it was, oh, I hate my life. I hate who I am. So let me just drink it all away and just keep pumping out fucking YouTube videos. I don't have to do that shit anymore. You know, like, I'm happy with who I am. Get fucked.